There are a lot of people suffering around the world, and we really have the knowledge and the experience and the medications available to stop it. There's not the political will and maybe the voice of the population driving it. And I think that's what makes everything so frustrating, is that we could do it.
What great scientific advances we have made. The international pain community certainly has reason to be proud of itself. But perhaps there'll be a touch of shame because of the implementation gap.
There is an enormous crisis in untreated pain, and one of the reasons that I think makes it such a crisis is that pain is such a treatable problem.
This man, after 5 Indian rupees worth of morphine, could sit up and have a cup of tea. Collective voice is necessary, and they have no voice. They are mute. We need to be their voice. Till then, we are not getting anywhere.
There are many world problems that we don't have the solutions to, but we absolutely have the solution. And so what that means is millions of people are dying in agony, and that doesn't have to be.
Their suffering is mute. They have no voice. If they scream, it's heard in their neighborhood, nowhere else.
Much as governments have other priorities, ensuring that patients can access pain control medicines doesn't change a lot to their budgets.
80% of the globe out there remains in darkness. And till we have a strategy for that 80%, I believe the global community has failed.
It is our responsibility, each one of us. We are not going to put the blame on governments only, on the policymakers only. I think we are the policymakers in our capacity. Because whether I'm in a community, whether I'm in a hospital, I have a role to play. Even if it's just to tell someone that actually you can get a service in this area, we're playing a role. So we all have a responsibility to contribute towards improving the suffering of patients.